Now, those of us who have been organizing and arguing against the death penalty for some time, I think, have to face the fact that our side is not winning at the moment. The pro-death penalty people have been aggressive, and they've been successful. The death penalty has been reintroduced in New York, and there are plenty of people in high public office who want to introduce it in Massachusetts and Rhode Island and other states in this region. So the key questions, I think, that we have to ask ourselves are, why is this happening? Why this apparent rise in support for the death penalty, at least among politicians at the top of the system? And then, what can we do about it? What new initiatives do those of us who are opposed to the death penalty need to begin thinking about? And important as the ethical and legal and socioeconomic arguments against the death penalty are, what I want to focus on in this middle section of what I say is this. I think we have to take a really hard look at the politics of the death penalty and understand those politics within the broader framework of the politics of crime in the U.S. now. Howard Zinn has already alluded to the fact that politicians in both major parties are exploiting what I would call a kind of crime hysteria at the moment. And I think we can use a phrase like crime hysteria, not because people don't actually suffer from crime. Of course they do. Most of them, people of color, poor people living in inner cities in this country. But I think we have to speak of a crime hysteria because most kinds of crime haven't actually increased in recent years. I mean, you don't have to look at small progressive-minded publications or anti-death penalty publications to find this out. Time magazine ran a whole cover story on it in their January 15th issue, the thesis of which was that many kinds of crime, most kinds of violent crime, are in fact not on the rise. And yet we see politicians in both parties making get tough on crime a major emphasis of their campaigns and major parts of their policy. And the social and economic consequences of this manipulation of crime are devastating. They've created what Manning Marable calls a political economy of imprisonment. And I know a lot of you are familiar with the material facts of this, but some of them bear repeating. 1.5 million people plus in prison at the moment in the United States. More than 110,000 people in California alone are in prison. 30% of black men between the ages of 20 and 29 are either in prison, on parole, or waiting for trial. 2% of the adult male workforce is in prison in the United States.